I welcome you all for my lecture on drugs from the sea or drugs from the ocean. So I have divided this talk in four modules. In session one, I'll be talking about background information. So why we need more drugs? There are a lot of drugs available in market. So why we need more drugs and what is the importance of natural products in drug discovery? In session two, I'll be covering marine biodiversity and chemical ecology. So marine biodiversity is there and the organisms are communicating with each other by using some chemicals. So that is nothing but chemical ecology. And in third topic, I'll be explaining how this chemical ecology can be linked to marine natural products and further to drug discovery. My fourth module is depending on drugs which are currently in market and the drugs which are currently in clinical trials. So let's start with session one, which is background information. So why we need more drugs? If you visit any pharmaceutical store or pharmacy, you'll be seeing that a lot of medicines are already available. Then why we need more drugs? These are the reasons. First, emerging diseases. WHO, that is World Health Organization, in 2015 has generated a list of diseases which are emerging diseases, mostly infectious diseases. There are pathogens which are showing outbreak suddenly, and presently there is no medical cure available for those pathogens, to kill those pathogens or for those diseases. Apart from infectious diseases, there are also non-infectious diseases like mental health or injuries, these kind of diseases where there is no immediate treatment is available. So these are emerging diseases. Second, growing antibiotic resistance. I'll be spending couple of slides on antibiotic resistance. What is meaning by antibiotic resistance? Third one is many drugs have awful side effects, mostly anti-cancer drugs. These drugs are having dangerous side effects. And fourth is some existing drugs are so expensive that common people cannot afford these drugs. Coming to infectious diseases, these are the infections like hospital-acquired bacterial pneumonia, healthcare-associated infections, ventilator-acquired pneumonia, respiratory tract infection. So there are many infections which are caused by deadly pathogens. And these infections can be treated by using antibiotics which are presently in market like linezolid, vancomycin, daptomycin. There are several antibiotics presently available. But if you see, when you visit any doctor, you can see that the prescription is loaded with antibiotics. Okay, here is an example I can give. In Delhi, it was surveyed and it was noticed that 21% prescriptions are loaded with antibiotics. Vellore, Mumbai, here are the figures. So all the doctors or most of the doctors, they give prescription where there are a lot of antibiotics are recommended. So this is a main issue. Misuse of antibiotics, either in patients or in aquaculture or in environmental studies, are causing resistance in these pathogens against all of these antibiotics. So if you see now, most of these drugs are not effective or their effect is reduced because there is a resistance developed by microbes against these antibiotics. So here is some background information about antibiotic resistance, especially rise in MRSA. MRSA means methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. So you can see rise in MRSA to 29% to 47% in 2015. So there is a rise in this particular group of organisms. Then emerging resistance against chloramphenicol, cipro, levo, norfloxacin, gentamicin, oxytetracycline, and several antibiotics which are currently in market are ineffective or their effect is reduced because of regular exposure of these antibiotics to the pathogens. So these are two pathogens which are causing most of the infections. Those are Staphylococcus species and Streptococcus species. You can see 29% Staphylococcus species are getting used to the antibiotics. So there is a resistance developed in this pathogen. Then Streptococcus, similar case, almost 25%. So in 2015, globally, 12.9 into 10 to 9 units of antibiotics were consumed. And here, our position, India is fourth highest globally antibiotic consumption. The total share is 3% global consumption. So this particular figure shows that we need more antibiotics because the antibiotic resistance strains are increasing. We have seen why we need more drugs to treat infectious diseases. Now let's talk about the cancer drugs. Why we need more cancer drugs? See, mostly cancer drugs are used either in chemotherapy in the patient to reduce the growth of the cancer cells or to stop or slow down the growth of the cancer cells or to stop the metastasis. Metastasis means spreading of the cancer cells from one organism, one organ to other organ. So to stop the metastasis, these drugs are also useful. So second one is hormonal therapy. So some anti-cancer drugs are used to either to boost some of the hormones or to reduce the level of the some of the hormones, for example, in breast cancer case. So this is a hormonal therapy. Third one is immunotherapy. In immunotherapy, drugs are used to boost the immune system of the patient so that its own patient's own immune system can fight against the cancer or the against tumor. Fourth one is a targeted therapy. In targeted therapy, the mostly anti-cancer drugs are targeting towards the cancer cells, the gene of the cancer cells, for example. So these drugs are not effective against normal cells, but they are effective only against cancer cells. And fifth one is a supplementary therapy. Supplementary therapy is mostly for giving supplements to the patient. So patient is going through chemotherapy, then there are side effects of the chemotherapy. So to reduce these side effects, the supplementary therapy is given. There also some of the medicines are very useful. So most of these drugs, they don't cure the cancer, but they slow down the growth of the cancers. So we need some more drugs which can cure. The curing rate will be increased by using those drugs. Then many drugs are having side effects. As I mentioned you earlier, these drugs are having side effects. So sometimes the suffering from the cancer is less than the side effects of the chemotherapy. And third important point is most of these drugs are very expensive. So we need more drugs to treat cancers which can get more curing rate, which can give more curing rate, then side effects are less and which is cheaper also. So natural products is playing very important role in drug discovery. So natural product means organic compounds isolated from natural sources that are produced by pathways of primary or secondary metabolism in the organisms, either plants, animals or microorganisms. So nature has been source of medicinal products since long time with many useful drugs developed from terrestrial as well as marine sources. More than 50% of marketed drugs today are derived from natural sources. Means original molecule was isolated from the natural source like from plant or from animal, and now these molecules are being synthesized in the laboratory or in the company's manufacturing unit and supplied in the market. So I would like to give you a couple of examples of natural product drugs which are currently in market as a medicines to cure pathogens or as a medicines for to treat cancer. First one is penicillin. Alexander Fleming has discovered this particular molecule, penicillin, which is from fungi. So what he noticed that when he was growing some bacteria on his plate, there was an infection of fungi, and this particular mold, which is Penicillium species, it showed a inhibition of this bacteria. So he noticed this and he started thinking about something should be there, some chemical in this particular mold or in this particular fungi which is killing this pathogen. So this was the story behind the discovery of penicillin, and the penicillin is still being used to treat infection. Second one is cephalosporin. This was also discovered by one Italian scientist, and it is in use to treat infections. So both of these drugs, antibiotics, inhibit bacterial cell wall synthesis. Then coming to anti-cancer drugs from natural sources are concerned, anti-cancer natural product, for example, Taxol. Taxol was initially developed in 60s, okay, where National Cancer Institute from USA, they got one funded project to screen natural products for anti-cancer purpose. And this particular product was isolated from the bark of Taxus brevifolia. This is a plant, a Pacific plant, and from this particular plant, bark of this plant, this particular molecule was isolated. You can see the structure of this taxol. It was discovered in 60s, but it took almost 25 to 30 years to reach this particular product in market. So this molecule is useful in the treatment of ovarian and breast cancer, also used in stents to prevent restenosis, and major drug with sales over $1 billion per year. So major sale of this molecule. So these three examples, first one is penicillin, then cephalosporin, taxol. These are natural product drugs, means originally isolated from nature, from plants and organisms, animals, and now synthesized and used for the treatment. So I'm going to end my first module, that was on background information for natural product drug discovery. So in this particular module, what we saw that why we need more drugs. There are many drugs available. So why we need more drugs, and how can we explore natural products for discovering new drugs. So new drugs are needed to address the limitations of existing ones, and natural products could be the single most productive source of leads for the development of new drugs. The oceans are unique resource that provide a diverse area of natural products having therapeutic application. So ocean is having, or the sea is having, lot of organisms, plants, microorganisms, invertebrates and vertebrates. These organisms, for their own benefit, for example, for communication or for defense against enemy or for space competition, they produce lot of molecules. And these molecules, the study of these molecules comes under chemical ecology. So in my second session, we can see how marine biodiversity and chemical ecology is important to discover natural product based drugs for the treatment of many deadly diseases. Thank you.